Stenka mi Ljubljana, Stenka בדובינץ', מטריצות בלתי פורמליות של עבודה בגלריה מודרנה וכמה חיילי אומנות אחרים בסלובניה.
So for the past 15 years in Moderna Galleria, we have been working in close collaboration with the concerned part of the local art community in effort to redefine the role of the museum, both in the local and international context. The common concern of our museum and its art community is the development of a local art system that would be compatible with the wider international space. Together, we have been striving for the internationalization of our space. We see all this as a necessary precondition for a contemporary art system. The idea of contemporary art as national art seems to be as a contradiction in terms. One of the crucial steps we took away from the typical model of the Eastern European National Museum was to establish the Artist Collection 2000 Plus. So I might show you some images. So the collection was first time presented in this building. It's a former, I don't know why. So these are the images from the collection. And this was the first presentation in 2000 in the military building we call it Metelkova Street. And the collection is based on Eastern European art from the 1960s to the present. The majority of museums of modern art in Eastern Europe preserve national art collections. During the wars in Balkans, we at Moderna Galleria asked ourselves, what is the task of the museum and of art in general when war is raging in the immediate vicinity? In our search for an answer for this question, we began in 1994 for the first time to work closely with certain Ljubljana artists, in particular with the group Irvin and with the Bosnian artist Jadran Nadamović, who was living then in Ljubljana. We collected works by 14 international known artists. We asked each of them to donate, through our meditation, one of their major works, a work with a high market value, to the city of Sarajevo. So there were works like of Anish Kapoor, Richard Dickan, you know, all these big stars, Andres Serrano and so on. When it was founded in the year 2000, our international artist collection 2000 Plus was the world's first survey collection on Eastern European art and the region's key artists. This collection was not created as a consequence of some disaster, but was rather the result of well-considered decision. It is true, however, that we were able to put this collection together in a fairly short time, since back then, Eastern European artists did not carry the market price that at least some of them do today, which make them too expensive for their own local museums. So this is new situation in Eastern Europe museums. When we at the Moderna Galleria decided that it was necessary for a contemporary art museum to establish an international collection, we also decided which international context should be our priority. This was not any context, but rather the one which we had shared a post-war history. But because of this focus, our collection soon became an indicator of the political situation in Slovenia. And the main reason why the current Minister of Culture did not confirm the program for our recently acquired building in the former army barracks in Metelkovo district, which I presented the picture already. Clearly, Eastern European museum collections have a logic of creation that is quite different from that of Western collections. Museums in the former Yugoslavia, despite the fact that their holdings consisted mostly of national art from their own national republics, Slovenia, Croatia, Bosnia, you know, were not allowed to place too much explicit emphasis on this national aspect. After all, Tito's policy were aimed at the idea of the brotherhood and unity, which is very popular in terms of multiculturalism today in art world as well. So brotherhood and unity of the Yugoslav people was our ideology in that time. The museum collections reflected this ideology. The Central Museum of Modern Art in Belgrade was focused on collecting works by Yugoslav artists from all the Yugoslav nationalities, while the museum in the constituted republics placed greater emphasis on national collections. Various exhibitions of Yugoslav art, however, would circulate among all these museums. As we now know all too well, after the collapse of socialist regime, the suppressed nationalisms of the individual Yugoslav nationalities acquired tragic dimensions in the Balkan Wars of the 90s. The national leaders, Franjo Tuđman in Croatia and Slobodan Milošević in Serbia, appointed new directors for the museum in Zagreb and Belgrade, respectively. The museum in Belgrade especially became a fortress in which there were almost the beginnings of the nationalist cleansing of the collection. Also, at the time, it was impossible to borrow works by, for instance, Slovene artists from the Belgrade Museum, which has a large number of excellent Slovene works among its holdings. The Moderna Galleria did not have to deal with this sort of nationalism in the post-socialist period. For a nation of 2 million people who had never exhibited any hegemonic tendencies, such as were present in Serbia, the more strategic question was of the cultural kinship. Many Slovene cultural figures have always preferred to think of themselves as a part of the context of Central Europe rather than of, say, the Balkans or Eastern Europe. This made them feel more confident and stronger, since many see the Central European context as more advanced and more cultural. At the same time, however, it is true that Central Europe is without question one of our important cultural and historical contexts. Geographically, Slovenia is situated between Eastern and Western Europe, as well as between the Alps and Mediterranean. Various historical and political and economic factors also change the way these different spaces influence Slovene culture and art. Of all these contexts, we at the Moderna Galleria saw the context of Eastern Europe as our first priority. This was because in recent decades, we and the other Eastern European spaces had all been excluded for very similar reasons from international history and from the art system. Also, we all faced similar important tasks which still confront us today and will probably continue to do so for some time to come. These include, first of all, the processes of redefining history, which are a necessary condition for international dialogue on an equal basis. After the collapse of three previous regimes, we at the Moderna Galleria asked ourselves, how do we move forward? Over the past 15 years, we have emphasized primarily the question, what does contemporary mean? And what is the museum's appropriate context? For me, contemporary means the interaction between localized lived time and the processes of globalization, which are increasingly imposing a linear, measurable, and external time on specific spaces. Museums of modern art were, for the most part, established as the museums of contemporary art. With every passing decade, more history entered these museums, and eventually they stopped being museums of contemporary art and turned into historical museums. In the former Yugoslavia, museums of modern art would also regularly present contemporary art, but this was never at the forefront of their activity, and more radical art practices were only rarely presented. You could even say that in the socialist countries, contemporary art was marginalized to the youth and student culture centers, as Anna already mentioned before. Especially, of course, that part of contemporary that in way sought to raise social critical awareness. In the 1990s, at the Moderna Galleria, we at the Moderna Galleria tried to highlight contemporariness in various ways. Even when we were dealing with the earlier periods in the 20th century, Moderna Galleria is a 20th century museum. For major retrospectives of important Slovene artists, for example, we would invite contemporary artists to put the exhibition together. In this way, we created a dialogue between the past and the present. Things became more problematic when we tried to define what, in fact, is contemporary art. That it is not just any art being made today, but that is an art that is in one way or another, possesses a full critical awareness of its time. In the 1990s, like contemporary art itself, so too did the contemporary art museums begin to turn its attention to the social and political context. By doing this, it started losing more and more of its neutral position. At the Moderna Galleria, after we developed our response to the war in the Balkans, we turned our attention in the second half of the 90s to the Eastern European context. Our first big project in this regard was the exhibit Body and the East in 1998. So that was the Body and the East exhibition. This followed by our series of artist exhibitions. These exhibitions were all in one way or another aimed at redefining history. To date, we have organized 5 such exhibitions, which always engage in a dialogue with our collection, and they are all about the same questions on redefining the history of art. So these are some images from the series of artists exhibition. For example, this was the exhibition artist collection 2000 plus 23. So we did it in collaboration with the magazine, very active and radical magazine Maska from Ljubljana, and we invited some 100 artists the Maska magazine was writing about to select works from the collection and to propose the new works for the 2023. So it's not about past, but also about the future, that exhibition. So, and that was another exhibition from the series called Interrupted Histories. And it was about artists in the role of historians and archivists. So we presented some important Eastern European artists. For example, this is the archive of Polish artist Zofia Kulik, who has been collecting the information on different objects from Polish new avant-garde art from the beginning of 70s. And this was the new exhibition. So this was also from the same exhibition, Interrupted History, and the exhibition Seven Scenes, Moscow, Ljubljana, was about seven stereotypes on the Eastern Europe and Eastern European mentality, for example, laziness, utopianism, collectivism, cynicism, love of West, and so on. So we tried to present the Eastern European scenes as the virtues, like for example, laziness is not just a bad thing, you know, we all need to be lazy to think the things really deep sometimes. So after the war of the fall of socialist regimes, art museums in Eastern Europe had to deal with the urgent processes of transformation, which are still going on and which in some places have lagged behind more general socio-economic changes, while in the other places we are moving far ahead of such changes. Certain more progressive institutions stand as a rule for interests similar to those of contemporary artists and are currently fighting for similar goals. In the post-socialist period, artistic production underwent many changes that cultural policy has not been able to keep up with. It was the smaller non-governmental organizations that were best able to adapt to these changes. It is very important to mention here that most of the main figures in this organization in Ljubljana had been recruited from the very, very powerful civil society movement of the 1980s, which had made possible the development of innovative models for working as well as for producing art. Of the bigger institutions, the Moderna Galleria is the only one that had in similar way been following these changes, and so found it easier to connect with both these smaller spaces as well as with other big institutions like itself. Indeed, all of the essential changes that have taken place in the Moderna Galleria over the past 15 years were possible only because throughout this period the museum's interests have been aligned with the interests of the art community in Slovenia. The Moderna Galleria, along with other extremely active protagonists of the art scene in Slovenia, believes that the development of an art system in accord with the international art system must be one of the priorities of the country's cultural policy. For us, a developed art system means solid conditions for the production, presentation, and international distribution of art. It also means a developed art market, possibilities for ongoing theoretical analysis, and the autonomy of art and its spaces. In no strategic or legal document are the priorities of Slovenia's cultural policy written down in the way they are defined by the interests of the art community as I have listed them. The third is the objectives of our cultural policy goal is to mention providing major support for internationally comparable, superior achievements in art. The question of what constitutes a superior achievement in art, of course, can be answered in various ways. In practice, it It turns out that in recent years, the state has mainly favored projects of traditional art as superior, while it has pushed contemporary art into the margins again. Over the past 4 years, even since our current right-wing government came to power, the Moderna Galleria has experienced quite a few situations in which its professional autonomy was put in doubt. For more than 10 years, the Moderna Galleria's efforts on behalf of clearer definition of contemporary art have seemed problematic, and this has led to reductions in funding of our program. In recent years, however, the most painful point has been the Minister of Culture's disagreement with our plans for dividing the Moderna Galleria program between two buildings, both of which are currently in the process of being renovating. Last year, when we were already in the middle of our preparations for renovating the museum's main building, it became apparent that the Moderna Galleria would be left without adequate funding and even without a venue for its public operations. This year, after a delay or nearly a full year, work began on the renovation of our cramped and run-down building. The minister did indeed provide the funds for the renovation, but at the same time he used this as a good excuse for nearly ceasing to finance our program, saying that anyway, during the renovation, we wouldn't need to have a program. In response to this, we put together an exhibition last year already without any financial means whatsoever. It was called Every Man is a Curator, Jeder Mensch ist ein Kurator. Since we were not able to provide our usual conditions for the exhibiting artists other than our exhibition space, we decided to have an unjured, unselected show along the lines of Duchamp's Independence exhibition in 1917 in New York, where anyone at all could participate. More than 100 people of various backgrounds responded to our open invitation, from established artists to amateur artists to children. The exhibition also served as a kind of public forum where people had the chance to share their views on Slovenia's current cultural policy. So I can present some images. So this is already the image from the exhibition, and on the back wall you see written Za Slovenski film, and it means for Slovenian film, which was really the victim of the cultural policy in Slovenia. So the minister almost destroyed the film industry in Slovenia in last year, and this was the work of Slovene artist Marjetica Potrč in the Yellow Star. It is written Sodobna umetnost, which means contemporary art, and it referred, of course, to the situation where contemporary art was marginalized, and that was an installation of the young group of 10 artists from Slovenia. This action was instrumental in making the position of the Moderna Galleria and contemporary art more visible, and this in turn inspired the next action called Hosting the Moderna Galleria, which was initiated by Alenka Gregorič, the director of Škuc Gallery in Ljubljana. A platform for contemporary art developed around this initiative, in which some 20 different venues for contemporary art are currently participating, we decided on this action as a way to show solidarity with Moderna Galleria and also to come together to advocate for better conditions for contemporary art. In their inaugural statement, they explained why they were joining forces. I quote, to express support for Moderna Galleria and its endeavors to secure better working conditions during renovation, we have been organized activities which aim to mitigate the negative effects that the suspension of the gallery's activities have on modern and contemporary art. Our activities are also an appeal to institutions and individuals working in the field of contemporary art to establish a network platform to facilitate communication and collaboration. Slovenia has quite a good tradition of alternative ways of networking and working together. In the 1980s, especially, representatives of subculture scene came together in informal networks of activity, which made production easier and brought greater visibility. Among art movements, NSK's Neue Slowenische Kunst movement certainly holds pride of place in this regard with its group Leibach, Irwin, Scipio, Nasice, Red Pilot. The complex manner in which the Neue Slowenische Kunst groups collaborate with each other and with outside structures has often been illustrated in diagrams, some of which have also been included in the artworks by Irwin groups. Neue Slowenische Kunst used a diagram to illustrate the organizing principle of its activities right at the very start, in the mid-80s. So I have here an example of one of the diagrams, but some of the images are just... So here is the diagram. From the mid-80s, where you can see how the different groups from Neue Slowenische Kunst imagined then their collaboration together. So another characteristic aspect of Slovenia is that art spaces which focus the most on social criticism, such as the Škuc Gallery or Gallery P74, also began to deal with the marketing of art without, however, changing their primary orientation on social role. This tradition of including the conditions of productions of production right in the artistic field itself continues even today to give the Ljubljana art scene a specific awareness of the importance of self-organizations and production of our own economies, which ideally should contribute to the development of the local art system. The project hosting Moderna Galleria, and here I can show you just the example of the program from the hosting Moderna Galleria. The project hosting Moderna Galleria points yet to another specific aspect of Slovene space, namely the linking of individual art spaces in which similar informal interests and content are often more important than their former status. Through this platform, our institution has joined up with mainly smaller non-governmental organizations and not so much, for instance, with the bigger museum institutions like ourselves. The legal frameworks of Slovene cultural policy do in fact define a network of galleries and museums which are organized in a hierarchical structure depending on territories and collections they cover. But the cultural policy encourages collaboration primarily only within a such network. The basic mission of museums and galleries is rationalized on the basis of their status and does not include much possibility for any sort of flexible responses to the here and now. The project hosting the Moderna Galleria is intended as a way to present Moderna Galleria exhibitions in other sites during the time the museum is closed for renovation. But another of project's ambition is to re-establish a space for civil society and the alternative creation of cultural policy. This year, through the platform hosting Moderna Galleria, A number of different programs are taking place, as you can see, which are being hosted by what is now more than 20 participating organizations, mainly NGOs, but also a few public institutions. One of the first exhibitions, which we organized at the beginning of the year at the Schutz Gallery, bore the title The Schengen Women. It presented a unique commentary on the new borders in Europe. At the start of 2008, a few weeks after the Schengen Treaty came into effect in Slovenia, our country assumed the presidency of the European Union. Also, EU declared 2008 to be the European Year of Intercultural Dialogue, and Slovenia too has developed several programs in response to this declaration. Ever since Slovenia became a member of the EU, the expectations was that our country would create stronger ties between Europe on the one hand and the Balkans and the Eastern Europe on the other. For this reason, the Slovene Ministry for Foreign Affairs has also founded a few projects connected with the Balkans. Slovenia's foreign policy, then, is currently adapting itself to European demands, while our internal policy still refuses to allow a program that would include, for instance, the permanent presentation of our collection of Eastern European art. The exhibition Schengen Women sought to point to the fact, during this time of the Slovene presidency of the EU and this year of international intercultural dialogue, that for the Balkan and Eastern Europe women, no dialogue can be a dialogue between equals. So now I have to show you some images from the exhibition. Okay. The view of the real Europe through their eyes is sometimes as uncomfortable as the view of Gustave Courbet's painting L'Origine du Monde. The real nature of this world was what inspired the Serbian artist Tanja Ostojic to exhibit a photograph of a woman in the same pose as in L'Origine du Monde in Vienna in 2006, just prior to Austria assuming the EU presidency. Her photo, OT, untitled 2004, which she enlarged no enormous dimensions for the Europart billboard project, caused quite a scandal in Vienna. Although the woman in Ostojic's photograph has her legs spread open in the same way as the woman in Courbet's painting, she is not completely naked. She is wearing a blue panties with the EU's circle of stars. Following angry protests from the Austrian public, Ostojic's poster, as well as certain provocative posters by other artists, were taken down. For women, and especially women from the southeastern and eastern Europe, marriage is often a prerequisite if they want to become an EU resident. One might say that woman must drop her panties if she wants to acquire EU citizenship. Ostojic tested such EU immigration policy on herself between 2000 and 2003 as a part of her performance Looking for a Husband with an EU passport. For the marriage advertisement, she shaved her head and pubic hair, which made her look like a prisoner. As part of the project, she exchanged some 500 letters with men from various parts of the Western world. The performance ended with Ostojic marrying the German artist Clemens Golf, obtaining an international marriage certificate and all the other necessary documents for her visa and moving to Germany. Her eventual divorce from her husband in 2005 was also part of the performance project. In addition to these works by Ostojic, the Moderna exhibition, the Moderna Galleria exhibition in Schutz Gallery, also presented works by several other women artists, as well as one male artist, which problematized ideas and stereotypes about Eastern European women. The show examined the art and fate of women who happened to be on the wrong side of the border, but historically again today. But both historically and again today. In the past, this otherness was defined by the Iron Curtain. Today, it is defined by the Schengen Treaty, which excludes them from the Europe without borders. Both in the past and today, there are many Eastern European women artists who have problematized various ideas and stereotypical images about Eastern European women, from the androgynous partisan and communist to the poor woman who does not match up to the Western media images of beauty, to the refugee and prostitute in today's period of post-socialist transition. So here are some other, Sanja Ivekovic's work and another, and Tadej Pogačar, the only man at the exhibition. He presented the work from Tirana related to the organization which deals with the problems of the former prostitutes and trafficking of people in Albania. You know, there is a really serious problem with this in that country. To illustrate the present political climate in Slovenia, I would like to use an exhibition we organize under the evocative title Triglav, which means three heads, which is the name of our highest mountain, a national symbol, which also appears on the Slovene coat of arms. So here I have to find the images again. Can see the Slovene national symbol with the shape of the highest mountain. The exhibition was held at the Mala Galleria, or the Little Gallery, a small exhibition space we operate in the middle of the city that is separated from the main museum building. For more than a year, this has been the only space we own where we can carry out our exhibition program during the renovation of the main building. The creators of Triglav exhibition were three artists who all have the same name, Janez Janša, which is also the name of our prime minister. Approximately 1 year earlier, these three artists had legally changed their names to that of the prime minister and also enrolled in his political party, the Slovene Democratic Party. With their show, Triglav, at the Mala Galleria, the three Janezes drew attention to the local tradition of collective practices. They presented the 19, so these are the three Janezes. This is from the exhibition. So we presented the 1968 performance Mount Triglav by the group OHO, which you can see in the middle, as well as two reenactments of this piece, one by the group Irvin in 2004. So in the back, you see the Irvin. And their own in 2007. The significance of Mount Triglav, whose name is Freiheit, as I said, as a Slovene national symbol, was central to all three artist groups. In the original works, three members of OHO enacted Mount Triglav by draping a black cloth over their bodies with only their heads peeking through the holes. Like the three peaks of the mountain, the middle head was higher than the other two, which were more or less on the same level. This action was carried out in the center in Ljubljana, as I said, in 68, and affected passerby primarily through its absurdity in comparison to the ordinary day-to-day socialist life. Irwin chose the same location in the center of Ljubljana for their reenactment of the performance, but their action was intended primarily for the lens of the camera. For them, what was important was the artifact, a high-quality, well-framed photograph. More than simply redoing Kocho's performance, what interested Irwin was the idea of providing it with a higher quality of documentation, which in itself represents a unique commentary on the poverty of documentation for Eastern European art and its non-inclusion in circulation of works within the international art system. The three Janezes photographed themselves in a similar manner. That is, they wrapped themselves in the black cloth, but they did this on the mountain itself. They printed the photographs on paper, on the reverse side of which were, in fact, the three main Slovene newspapers. The Janezes were interested in newspapers which record various state anniversaries and national important events. When asked why they had officially changed their names, each of the three artists answered the same way: for personal reasons. Despite the fact that it is virtually impossible not to interpret their act as a critical stance towards Janez Janša's administration, the artists themselves have never confirmed this for the public record. But even so, by changing their names to Janez Janša, they in fact did adopt a critical stance toward the state, and in particular toward the present Slovene government, in which until recently all posts seemed to be occupied by a single person, Janez Janša. For a while, there was a real fear that our young democracy might sliding back into a harsher form of government. But around the time, Janša's name started appearing also on the art scene. Capital began to flex its muscles in our country, and in the past 10 months has subdued even those media outlets that were once perceived as being essentially in the hands of the Prime Minister. The countries in transition have seen quite a few situations where social anachronisms of various types appear to be on the verge of jeopardizing their bandit contemporary democracies. It is now becoming increasingly clear that the neoliberalist processes of prevailing the market mechanisms are decentering positions of power, and that the state apparatus is growing weaker. The various positions of power, which are concerned not only in politics and capital, but also in the knowledge produced by the various systems of social life, have long colonized the private sphere. The three Janezes have in effect established a situation which makes evident the fact that a part of the government of society is also based on the construction of self-regulating or self-correcting selves. It only appears that our names, along with our documents and fingerprints, are proof of our individuality. The fact that no one has publicly raised any eyebrows at this artistic appropriation of the Prime Minister's name tells us also that art is increasingly less able to serve as a representation of the state. Politicians' image are now shaped by the media, and the goal is a polished look. It is rare in Western democracies that the abuse of the name or image of politicians should result in serious consequences. And this is understandable. The space of contemporary art is in the hands of the market rather than any political ideology. But in countries where neoliberalism has not yet permitted all the pores of public life, art is still subject to the monopoly of state. It is not surprise that our artists still deal with the question of their own creativity in the context of the nation state and its phenomenon. Despite the fact that private capital has begun to penetrate the cultural sphere in the big way in Eastern European countries, public institutions and art production are still overwhelmingly depend on public funding. Also, the state has not set up any mechanism that would make it possible for public-private partnership to develop on a high quality level. It seems that the state still insists on its own exclusive position, for in this way it can at least control symbolic capital, if the control of real capital now largely eludes it. Undoubtedly, this sort of state is becoming an anachronism. But for contemporary art and its museums, the death of the state would in any case mean the loss of an important protector. Not the death of the state as we know it today, but rather of the state or any political structure that would defend the interest of the civil society. Okay, thank you.